Invasive giant hornets are a problem because they could potentially wipe out honeybees and impact America's food supply. We still don't know if they can be eradicated in North America, but the clock is ticking, driving scientists and locals to take action. Because we not only love, but depend on the native honeybee.
The honeybee is non-native.
Wait, what?
Well, in some of these species, that gets to another end of a definition. Some non-native species become naturalized. And that's kind of the opposite of invasive, and that is they become part of the ecosystem that they've been introduced to and fit into the ecosystem. And so there are naturalized non-native species as well as invasive non-native species.
Okay, so let's get this straight. Non-native species are the ones that have moved into new ecosystems. And like Frank says, such species can become either naturalized as a part of the ecosystem or invasive and disrupt the ecosystem. But species have been moving around the world for millions of years. So does that mean every plant and animal could have been considered non-native and potentially invasive at some point in Earth's history? Could North America's beloved honeybees have been, for a time, invasive and outcompeting native pollinators? What else?
Cats.
You're killing me, Frank.
Cats eat birds, eat small mammals, eat reptiles, and are responsible for hundreds of millions, if not billions, of birds being eaten every year. Cats are one of the most invasive species. And cats get a pass because people do like them.
They shouldn't get a pass. I'm gonna anger all the cat people. It's okay, I'm a dog person, I own it.